Mrs. Miller creates a note, an assessment, and a journal. That wonderful madness of the first few days of school is over, and Mrs. Miller is ready to explore one of her Edsby classes. Her Edsby class is a bit sparse at this point, but it's great that the students are already enrolled because Mrs. Miller loves her checklists, and she's already printed the student list a few times. She clicks on students, chooses between the three views, portraits, single column, or multiple columns, and clicks print. In the center of the class is the conversation and activity feed. Mrs. Miller starts by posting a note welcoming her students back to school and to their Edsby class. Mrs. Miller has a very clear plan for next week, and she's going to use the journal to outline the week ahead for her students. She writes a short summary and includes what she expects from her students. She wants her students to see this journal on Monday and not today. She just hovers over the journal, clicks edit, and simply changes the date. Notes can be about anything and appear in the feed immediately. Journals are focused on course content and outline student expectations such as homework or reading assignments. Journals can appear in the activity feed immediately, or they can be written in advance by choosing a date in the future. Mrs. Miller told the class about a test next week, so she clicks Assessment to add it to her Edsby class. First, she enters the name. This is the first assessment Mrs. Miller has created, so she has a choice of choosing the generic Unit 1 or creating a new unit with a name. She names the unit, chooses an assessment type. She wants her students to see the test, so the status field is fine. She sets the date of the test. Mrs. Miller has already written the test, so she sets the scheme to out of 25. When she clicks Share, the test is added to the activity feed and the class calendar. Her students can see the test details in the feed and in the calendar. Edsby looks after Mrs. Miller by updating the gradebook. Here is the test. Mrs. Miller can edit the test details by clicking on the name. The assessment is also added to the course plan. The course plan lays out assessments, lessons, and journals in a calendar view. Anything can be changed at any time. A unit can be changed by clicking on Edit. Lessons, assessments, and journals are edited by clicking on the name. When Mrs. Miller returns to the class, she decides to put her welcome message into pinned items. She just hovers over the item and clicks Pin. When the welcome message becomes old news, she can just unpin it by clicking on the pin. Now Mrs. Miller is ready to open the class to her students. There is a banner at the top of the page that indicates this class is not open to the students. She clicks Setup and changes this field to Students may open and participate in class. Mrs. Miller expects that her students will enjoy using Edsby to collaborate and help each other. Mrs. Miller and her students share this class and see the same content outlined in green. But only Mrs. Miller can see the items outlined in orange. When Mrs. Miller hovers over an item, she gets additional actions here and can delete items from the feed by clicking the X. And here's the review. Print a student list from the student panel. Notes can be about anything. Journals are dated and concentrate on what happens in class and what you want the students to be doing. Assessments are added to the feed, the calendar, the gradebook, and the course plan. Teachers and the students share the class, but teachers have exclusive tools and actions.